Maple Leaf Tracks is back in town, and they've brought their latest creation to the table. Will it rock you like a hurricane? Well, here I am, and we'll give it a shot at the Railyard. Soldier Summit, created by Maple Leaf Tracks, includes 100 miles of the Denver and Rio Grande mainline between Provo and Sunnyside in Utah, along with 50 miles of industrial spurs. The area is modeled as it was in the mid-90s, but running Union Pacific freight or even the California Zephyr doesn't look too out of place. In this part of the Rockies, the name of the game is coal. Both the Rio Grande and the Utah Railway, which has trackage rights on the line, haul vast quantities of it from the mines to Provo. Other traffic you'll see includes dirt trains and mixed freight. The scenery you'll encounter is very diverse. One minute you're racing through the desert, the next you're crossing plains, and after that you're chugging through the canyons. I'm glad MLT chose a line like this, because it's very different from what they've attempted before. Six types of engines are included with the pack, three for each railroad. My favorites are the DNRGW tunnel motors and Utah Railway's F45. Unfortunately, they do have their shortcomings. None of the bells work outside of the cabs, and you may find yourself using the same engine twice in one consist. For example, Utah Railway can use up to 12 engines on one coal drag, but only six are included here. Another issue is that there are no AI versions of the locomotives available. This means your computer has to work harder when you pass other trains. The freight equipment is also varied, both in what is included and in its quality. Some of the models like these tankers are really sharp, but some of the cars like the hoppers really need more weathering to look convincing. After the controversy surrounding the Greater Toronto Area's lack of scenery, it's understandable that there is this lingering question of, are they really back to their old selves? They have improved their style, but some aspects of the route are still problematic. Besides the rolling stock issues, some of the speed limits for the yards and industrial spurs aren't clearly labeled. Not all of the trees have winterized versions, and a couple of the models are outdated for where MSTS is now. But don't count it out just yet. Sure, it may have its sticking points, but to write this route off entirely would be a mistake. Issues like the bell and speed limits can easily be remedied with a patch. More than that, though, many portions of this line really are magnificent, especially the deserts and canyons. Furthermore, the activities, although very basic, do a good job of showing the operations of both the Utah Railway and the Rio Grande. GTA's quintessential problem was that if you weren't a GO Transiter via Rail fan, you probably would not like the route. But I don't think that's the case here. I've never been much of a Rio Grande fan, but I'm still having a lot of fun with this route. While this may not be their greatest route ever, and some of the route's difficulties may annoy the prototypical user, this project shows that MLT is willing to go beyond its comfort zone of routes lined with trees. All in all, it's a good line with plenty of detail and operations to keep you interested. I give Soldier Summit my seal of approval with a final score of 93%. And yes, there really is only one way to describe this return. Utah Railway can use up to 12 engines on one coal track, but they're... why?